corporate earnings season mm-hmm. in Canada, and we've seen a few misses. We saw what happened with Shopify. CN and CP have cut, I guess, some of their profits. What would you say overall? How did companies fare?
It's still pretty early on the Canadian side to get too deep into the details. We've had about 90 of the 300 plus companies in Canada report so far. It's been a really mixed bag. Very sector specific. Obviously extreme weakness in the energy and material sectors. Seen big year over year declines in earnings there. Surprises have been a mixed bag. In Canada, we're still kind of going through looking at the individual companies we own and evaluating those situations. I mean, you touched on a couple of the rails, lowering profit expectations. They've actually been in a pretty good foothold and running pretty hard lately. That's been aided by both an increase in shipments of crude by rail, but kind of negatively offset by the agricultural space.
Of the companies that have reported in Canada, I guess, who took you by surprise? You mentioned some surprises.
Yeah, so we added to Maple Leaf Foods on weakness there. They unfortunately hedged their pork product pricing as prices were rising earlier in the year. We've seen that come off lately. That provided an opportunity of weakness in that stock for us to add. They also broke out their plant-based protein division for the first time, which has formerly been accretive to earnings. But now, as they're investing heavily into that space, actually weighed a little bit on profitability.
So help me understand, because this is all happening against the backdrop of GDP, which is actually doing well. So what do you attribute that to? Is that just temporary weakness? Is that a sign of things to come? What is that?
So global GDP and even domestic or North American GDP has been pretty strong. The consumer remains extremely resilient. We've seen the lowest unemployment level since the 1960s. I think that that's a positive backdrop. But I mean, you rewind 2-3 months ago, the yield curve had inverted. There was a lot of recessionary fears. Those seem to be fading and providing a bit of a lift to markets now, as those professional investors that were waiting on the sidelines are taking this as a positive opportunity to maybe enter into names and bid the markets higher. Unfortunately, the TSX kind of lagged all most other developed markets last month, posting a negative return, still below the all-time highs, where each day we're seeing the S&P and the Dow kind of break through yesterday's close and post even higher highs.
So we saw companies like Suncor and Husky and Imperial, report lower than expected earnings. And I'm just wondering whether or not we can expect to see consolidation in the energy sector. I mean, it's just a sign of more weakness in the oil patch. So do you think we'll see more consolidation?
Attractive valuations bring consolidation. The small cap companies in the oil sands are in a very challenging position right now. We've seen those valuations kind of falling off a cliff. There's really limited access to capital for those companies. And so their best strategic option in a lot of cases is to partner with bigger firms. So we're seeing two trends, consolidation, as well now kind of with in Canada moving their headquarters to the States, TransCanada changing their name to TC Energy. You've kind of seen this shifting landscape in the Canadian oil patch. It's a very challenging environment. You look at price to cash flow, kind of all valuation metrics, and these companies are at multi-year lows right now. Very attractive from a valuation standpoint, but the obvious political headwinds remain in trying to get our energy to the market. Keystone right now is in a force majeure, meaning they've had to tell their clients that they have commitments to. Today they announced they're expecting 30% less production from that pipeline to the people that they've made commitments to because of a leak. They haven't actually even identified where the leak is at this point. So we see another 7 to 12 days there. That's negatively impacting WCS spreads, Western Canadian Select versus global benchmark pricing. So it's a really challenging environment for our friends in the prairies and in Alberta that rely on this as a large source of GDP, coupled with the fact that they still send transfer payments east. You know, that's spurring even more geopolitical tension interprovincial between our provinces, yeah.
Looking south of the border, a very different picture with the U.S. earnings. I mean, there was all kinds of talk of earnings recession, and we've seen, I guess, better than forecast expectations there. What do you attribute that to?
Yeah, so again, I think that's an overblown on the downside. People kind of looked into this inverted yield curve, trade tensions, geopolitical concerns around the world, and you know the recession indicator fears were ticking higher. A lot of that's dissipated. We're expecting hopefully a phase one trade deal between President Xi Jinping and Donald Trump. Hopefully in the coming weeks, maybe even days, that would be another boost to the market. And so a lot of that macro headwinds faded. It never actually seeped into corporate earnings. Again, back to the consumer, that's about 2/3 of our spending here in North America. The consumer remains strong. When we look at US earnings so far, much deeper into the season, in aggregate in each sector, we've seen earnings surprises, all to the upside. But similar to the story here in Canada, big negative year-over-year earnings declines in both energy and materials, and actually technology a little bit as well.
So if you're an investor, what sectors should you be looking at?
One of our bigger overweights is in the industrial sector. We think that we're going to see a rise to maybe not prolific economic growth, but definitely some sort of growth here as we close out the year and go into Q1. And so we think overweighting those cyclical sectors that have a bit of a yield tilt is kind of our focus in our fundamental equity strategy. So as you get that rise back to growth, sectors like industrials, technology, or financials tend to lead the way higher. Conversely to what we saw at the beginning of the year, where you saw more of those interest rate sensitive sectors, think utilities, REITs, staples, as bond yields trended lower, their bond-like proxies, they really led us higher. Kind of had people piling into low-vol ETF type of solutions because they tilt in that direction. So I think that you might actually see this return to growth and have the market leadership shift back to the industrial, even materials to a degree, and cyclically oriented sectors like that.